Welcome to Into Our Dreams, a musical celebration. Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein II, possibly the most prolific musical duo of the 20th century. Over the course of their 16-year partnership, the two would write 11 musicals, win every major award from a Tony to the Pulitzer, and establish the American musical into the art form we know today. Tonight, we will look at the songs that shaped a generation and made Broadway the place to be. It all started in 1943 when Rodgers and Hammerstein created their first production, Oklahoma. Our country was steeped in war and in turmoil when the two shared the story of frontier men and women in search of the American dream. Successful is an understatement. Oklahoma was and is the benchmark by which all other musicals are compared. They may not have known it at the time, but Rodgers and Hammerstein were starting a musical revolution. It was something to which they just couldn't say no.
Bye! Oh!
Will Parker's back from Kansas City. He's looking for you.
Will Parker, I didn't count on him being back so soon.
I can see that.
The peddler man's gonna drive me to the Vox Social. I got up sort of a tasty lunch.
I know, Annie. Have you tucked up with that peddler man?
No, not yet.
But you're promised Will Parker, ain't you?
Not what you might say promised. I just told him maybe.
Don't you like him no more?
Course I do. There will never be nobody like Will.
Then what about that peddler man?
There will never be nobody like him neither.
Well, which one do you like the best?
Whatever one I'm with.
Well, you are a silly.
Now, Lori, you know they didn't nobody pay me no mind up to this year, kind of I was scrawny as a beanpole. Then I sort of rounded up a little. Now the boys act different to me.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Nothing wrong. I like it. I like it so much when a feller talks purty to me, I get all shaky from horn to hoof. Don't you?
Can't think what you're talking about.
Don't you feel kind of sorry for a feller when he looks like he wants to kiss you?
Well, you can't just go around kissing every man that asks you. Didn't everybody ever tell you that?
Yeah, well, they told me. It ain't so much a question of not knowing what to do. I know what's right and wrong since I've been 10. I heard a lot of stories and I reckon they are true about how girls are put upon by I'm with a feller, I forget. I'm just a girl who can't say no. I'm in a terrible fix. I always say, come on, let's go. Just when I ought to say nix. When a person tries to kiss a girl, I know she ought to give his face a smack. Sort of want to kiss him back. I'm just a fool when lights are low. I can't be prissy and quaint. I ain't the type that can faint. How can I be what I hate? I can't say no.
You may not realize it, but in 1949, when Rodgers and Hammerstein released their fourth musical production, South Pacific, they were well ahead of their time. The story of an American nurse stationed in the South Pacific during World War II openly explored the themes of racial prejudice and acceptance. While writing the piece, Oscar Hammerstein was worried that the audience would reject it due to the progressive nature of the plot. But at the end, the show was a huge success, winning the Pair 10 Tony Awards and the Pulitzer Prize for Drama.
Ladies, you don't have to worry about me anymore because it's all off.
With him?
Uh-huh.
Smart girl, Nellie.
I'm gonna break it off clean before it's too late.
Do you think you can?
Before I go any further, I just better not get started. Don't you think so too, Gracie?
Yeah, I do.
You do, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I guess I do too. Well, you don't have to look so dramatic about it. These things happen all the time. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way. Get the picture? I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms. I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms. I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms. Send him on his way. Don't try to patch it up.
Tear it up, tear it up.
Wash him out, dry him out.
Push him out, fly him out.
Cancel him and let him go.
Yeah, sister.
I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way. If the man don't understand you, if you fly on separate beams, waste no time, make a change. Ride that man right off your range. Rub him out of the roll call and drum him out of your dreams. Oh, if you laugh at different comics,
if you root for different teams,
waste no time, wait no more. Show him what the door is for. Rub him out of the roll call and drum him out of your dreams.
You can't light a fire when the wood's all wet.
No.
You can't make a butterfly strong.
Uh-uh.
You can't fix an egg when it ain't quite good. And you can't fix a man when he's wrong. You can't put back a petal when it falls from a flower, or sweeten up a feller when he starts turning sour. Oh, 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 drop him in the nearest ditch. Rub him out of the roll call and drum him out of your dreams. Oh, 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 oh. I went and washed that man right out of my hair. I went and washed that man right out of my hair. I went and washed that man right out of my hair and sent him on his way. Wash that man right out of her hair. She went and washed that man right out of her hair. She went and washed that man right out of her hair
and sent him on his way.
When Rodgers and Hammerstein began work on the musical version of Cinderella, they wrote specifically for its star, Julie Andrews. It was the one and only production they wrote for television, having aired first in 1957, again in 1965 with Leslie Ann Warren, and yet again in 1997 with pop star Brandy in the title role and Whitney Houston as the fairy godmother. In fact, Cinderella did not make it to a Broadway stage until 2013, nearly 56 years after it was written. But it was the 2018 Oak Knoll production that has stayed in our hearts.
Softer than a dozen. Neck is no wider than a swan. She's always deep, she's a dame. After the groundbreaking triumph of their first musical, Oklahoma, Rodgers and Hammerstein needed to follow up their enormous success with another memorable story. They had established a sort of formula with scenes leading into songs to further the plot of their heroes, something that had not been done in the musical comedies of the 1920s and 30s. They found their muse in the story of a young girl from Maine who falls in love with a boy from the wrong side of the tracks. This show would explore challenging themes of abuse, repentance, and redemption, and have one of Rodgers and Hammerstein's most famous scores, including the song, You'll Never Walk Alone. Even though the material was challenging for its audience, it would become one of the most produced musicals in history, and it would be called Carousel.
June is busting out all over. Buds are busting out of bushes, and the romping river pushes every little wheel that wheels beside the mill. June is busting out all over. The feeling is getting so intense that the young Virginia creepers have been hugging the bejeepers over all the morning glories on the fence. Because it's June, 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 just because it's
my sister's even loonier,
and my mom is getting kittenish with pals.
June is busting out all over.
Two ladies, the men are paying court. Lots of ships are kept at anchor just because the captain's hanker for a comfort they can only find in port.
Because it's June, 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 just because it's
spell it with an X?
That's only when there's more than one.
Oh.
Julie,
I've been busting to tell you something lately.
You have?
Reason I didn't care to tell you before is because you didn't have a feller of your own. Now that you've got one, I can tell you about mine.
Oh, Carrie, what's his name?
His name is Mr. Snow, and an upstanding man is he. He comes home every night in his round bottom boat with a net full of herring from the sea. An almost perfect beau, as refined as a girl could wish. But he spends so much time in his round bottom boat that he can't seem to lose the smell of fish. The first time he kissed me, the whiff of his clothes knocked me flat on the floor of the room. But now that I love him, my heart's in my nose, and fish is my favorite.
Late 1940s saw Rodgers and Hammerstein as almost unstoppable. In 1945, they would pen the hit remake of a classic Will Rogers film, State Fair. It would be their only movie score, winning them their first and only Oscar for the song It Might As Well Be Spring. Still, the subject matter was light, something the musical duo were not used to with their statement-making Broadway shows. They would then turn to the complex story of a British governess in the Siamese monarchy in The King and I. To help them bring the royal court to life, they called upon famed choreographer Jerome Robbins to stage the elaborate dance sequences. When it finally opened in 1951, The King and I was the most expensive show to be produced on Broadway, but it was a blockbuster success, having been revived 4 times in the last 65 years.
The things I used to like, I don't like anymore. I want a lot of other things I've never had before. It's just like Mother says, I sit around and mope, pretending I am wonderful and knowing I'm a dope. I'm as restless as a willow in a windstorm. I'm as jumpy as a puppet on a string. I'd say that I have spring fever, but I know it isn't spring. I am starry-eyed and vaguely discontented, like a nightingale without a song to sing. Oh, why should I have spring fever when it isn't even spring? I keep wishing I were somewhere else, walking down a strange new street, hearing words that I have never heard from a man I've yet to meet. I'm as busy as a spider spinning daydreams. I'm as giddy as a baby on a swing. I haven't seen a crocus or a rosebud or a robin on the wing. But I feel so gay in a melancholy way that it might as well be spring. It might as well be spring.
Now that last line was, "Hello, have a good day." That wasn't very clear. I want to hear the beginnings and the ends of your words. Once again now, shoulders back, chins up, and big smiles, because this is your school song, and you love your school. Lady Tiang, will you start?
Blue is ocean, red is Siam, and green is Burma.
Thank you, Lady Tiang. Will you take my place? Today, we have a surprise. A new map just arrived from England. It's a present to us from His Majesty, your King.
The Lord of the Light.
Yes, the Lord of the Light.
The widest Siam.
No, Siam's not that small.
Yes.
Yes, wait, let me show you. England is smaller than Siam.
For many years before I came here, Siam to me was just like that spot. Now I've lived here for more than a year. I've met the people of Siam. I'm beginning to understand them.
You like us?
I like you very much indeed.
Very ancient saying, but a true and honest thought, that when you are a teacher, by your pupils you'll be taught. As a teacher I've been learning, you'll forgive me if I boast, and I've now become an expert on the subject.
Getting to know you.
heart wants to beat like the wings of the birds that rise from the lake to the trees. My heart wants to sigh like a chime that flies from a church on a breeze, to laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones. Like a lark who is learning to pray, I go to the hills when my heart is lonely. I know I will hear what I've heard before. My heart will be blessed with the sound of
with our efforts. Out of 28 postulates, 16 or 17 are ready to enter the novitiate. Let's consider the doubtful ones again. There's Ermengarde.
Well, there's no doubt about Ermengarde. Religious life is never for the pious.
You mean the pretentiously pious, Sister Berta. There's Christina, and there's Maria.
Well, after last night, there can't be a doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Berta.
Reverend Mother, I've brought Maria. She's waiting.
Sister Sophia, the Mistress of Postulates and the Mistress of Novices do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
I love her dearly, but she always seems to be in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I said.
She climbs a tree and scrapes her knee. Her dress has got a tear.
She waltzes on her way to Mass and whistles on the stair.
And underneath her wimple, she has curlers in her hair.
I even heard her singing in the Abbey.
She's always late to chapel,
but her penitence is real.
She's always late to everything except for every meal. I hate to have to say it, but I very firmly feel Maria's not an asset to the Abbey.
Say it, Sister Margareta.
Maria makes me laugh.
How do you solve a problem like Maria?
How do you catch a cloud and pin it down?
How do you find a word that means Maria?
A flipper, a gibbet,
a will-o'-the-wisp, a clam.
Many a thing you know you like to tell her. She'd ought to understand.
But how do you make her stay?
Listen to all you say.
How do you keep a wave upon the sands?
Oh, how do you solve a problem like Maria?
How do you hold a living in your hands?
When I'm with her, I'm confused, out of focus and bemused, and I never know exactly where I am.
Unpredictable as weather, she's as flighty as a feather.
She's a darling.
She's a demon.
She's a lamb.
She'll outpester any pest, drive a hornet from its nest.
She could throw a whirling dervish out a whirl.
She is gentle, she is wild.
She's a riddle, she's a child.
She's a headache,
she's an angel.
She's a girl.
How do you solve a problem like Marie? How do you catch a cloud and pin it down? How do you find a word that means Maria?
A flippity jibbit,
a will-o'-the-wisp, a clown.
Many a thing you know you'd like to tell her. Many a thing she ought to understand.
But how do you make her stay
and listen to all you say?
How do you keep a wave up on the sand?
Oh, how do you solve a problem like Maria?
Thank you for joining us on our journey through the music of Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein. It seems only fitting that we would conclude our show with the final musical the two would write. Before the untimely death of Oscar Hammerstein in 1960, the two collaborated on the story of an Austrian captain and a nun who comes to help heal their family through the gift of song. Oh, and she marries him too. The Sound of Music contains more hit songs than any other musical, and the film version starring Julie Andrews was the most successful Broadway adaptation film ever made. As we present our final number, please feel free to sing along if you know the words. I have a feeling you might.
Now that it's just us, would you mind telling me your names again and telling me how old you are? Now you're?
I'm Liesl, I'm 16, and I don't need a governess.
I'm glad that you told me, we'll just be friends.
I'm Friedrich, I'm 14, I'm a boy.
Boy? Why, you're almost a man.
I'm Brigitte.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Louisa.
I'm Brigitte, she's Louisa, and she's 13. I'm 9, and I think your dress is the ugliest one I ever saw.
Brigitte, you mustn't say a thing like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
If I did think so, I wouldn't say so.
I'm Kurt. I'm 11.
Almost. It's a very nice age to be 11. Almost.
I'm Marta, and I'm gonna be 7 on Tuesday, and I like a pink parasol.
Pink is my favorite color, too. And you're Gretel. Now I'm going to tell you all something. I've never been a governess before.
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing you have to do is tell Father to mind his own business.
Louisa, don't! I like her!
What is this?
My guitar.
Well, when did you bring it for?
For when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Of course you sing! Everybody sings! Now what songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't? Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing.
Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start. When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you begin with Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi. The first three notes just happen to be Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La.
Come, I'll make it easier for you. Listen.
Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Fa, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow so. A drink with jam and bread that will bring us back to Do, oh, oh, oh.
Do.
A deer, a female deer.
Ray.
A drop of golden sun.
Me.
A name I call myself.
Fa.
A long, long way to run.
So.
A needle pulling thread.
La.
A note to follow so. A drink with jam and bread that will bring us back to
Do, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow so.
Do, re, mi, fa, so, and so on are only tools we use to build a song. Once we have these notes in our heads, we can build a million different tunes.
How?
By mixing them up. Listen.
do, la, fa, mi, do, re. Now you do it.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
Now put it all together.
Do.